Good morning. How is it that God's people lie about the Lord? This morning we've come to Jeremiah 5, verses 12 to 19. They have lied about the Lord and said, "It is not He, neither will evil come upon us, nor shall we see sword or famine, and the prophets become wind, for the Lord is not in them. Thus shall it be done to them. Therefore, thus says the Lord God of hosts, because you speak this word, behold, I will make my words in your mouth fire, and this people wood, and it shall devour them. Behold, I will bring a nation against you from afar, O house of Israel, says the Lord. It is a mighty nation, it is an ancient nation, a nation whose language you do not know, nor can you understand what they say. Their quiver is like an open tomb. They are all mighty men, and they shall eat up your harvest and your bread, which your sons and daughters should eat. They shall eat up your flocks and your herds. They shall eat up your vines and your fig trees. They shall destroy your fortified cities in which you trust with the sword. Nevertheless, in those days, says the Lord, I will not make a complete end of you. And it will be when you say, why does the Lord our God do all these things to us? Then you shall answer them, just as you have forsaken me and served foreign gods in your land, so you shall serve aliens in a land that is not yours." So how did they lie about the Lord? Well, they told each other, well, God's not the source of these problems that are coming down on us. It's not God. It's just some other thing. Not only that, but they are certain that they're going to avoid judgment. Everything's going wonderfully. Listen to the prophets. Well, the prophets have become wind. So they have the voices of the prophets that are confirming to them, hey, don't worry about it. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Everything's going to be fine. And so the prophets are still prophesying. The prophets haven't disappeared. And you know, when they departed from God, the prophets didn't disappear. The stars didn't go out. The rain didn't stop coming. God sends His rain on the evil and on the just. Nothing changed. It just seemed like everything just kept going on. And then the messages of the prophets began to be in harmony with what the political leaders wanted. They didn't stop prophesying. They didn't stop vocalizing. God did stop speaking through them when they became unfaithful. But the prophets just kept on chattering, and the people kept on listening to the prophetic chatter. It wasn't prophetic. It was just political. It was just human. So everything's going along wonderfully, and don't worry, happy endings all around. So they stuck their fingers in the air, and they checked to see which way the wind was blowing, and out came the words. Isn't it true that when a society becomes kind of old and tired, it stops holding leaders accountable? And we talked about these leaders several times that are found in Jeremiah: the king, the princes, the priests, and the prophets, the institutions that were there that they just trusted in, that God was working through those institutions. Well, surely those things won't fail. But when they departed from God, point by point, the lights went out. And so they're getting this false message of relax when they need to repent and come close to Him. And here we have the promise again at verse 18. Haven't we heard this 3 or 4 days in a row? Yet I will not make a complete end of her. God is still loves His people, and He's still going to work through them and for them. He's going to have to overturn just about everything, but He hasn't given up on them. They could care less about Him sometimes, but He is still working for their salvation. That's the God that we're talking about in all these presentations. Let's pray to that God. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for your persistence, your relentless love, your relentless pursuit of what's good for us. Lord, we just pray that you will give us eyes to see, ears to hear. We pray that our leaders today will not become wind. We pray that you, Lord, will speak to and through your people. Help us to be faithful, Lord. Help us to be true to the Bible, and help us to have our eyes wide awake so that we can see the strange things that are happening in our day and react as Christians, not as worldlings. Please, Lord, help your church. Watch over us, Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, there it is. They didn't hold the leaders accountable. The leaders became unaccountable, and God comes in with a giant reset. But you know what? We can be faithful individually and work in our own local congregation. And let's see what God does. God be with you this day. Don't lose hope.